everyone, and welcome back to my channel. And if you're new, what up? Today I am bringing you guys all of the perfumes from my collection that I feel like would work perfectly for the fall season, perfectly in the somewhat cold but not too cold weather. You know, sometimes it might be cooler in the morning time, but then it kind of warms up in the afternoon, or it may stay cold all day. It just really depends, but it's not super super frigid freezing cold. These are the perfumes that I feel like would work for this time. So yeah, some of these are going to be perfumes that you guys have heard before a million times, and that's only because they really are perfect for the season. And then some of these might be newer to you might be hearing about them for the first time. So I hope you guys can enjoy this video and get something out of it, and let's just get right into all of the perfumes that I think are for the fall. Okay, so I really don't have any type of order to this, so I'm just gonna start picking up fragrances. So the first one is going to be my Paco Rabanne Pure XS perfume. This is newer to me, but the more I smell this, the more I get this really syrupy, deep, salty note from this that I just feel like is so heavy and deep that it wouldn't work for any other time except for like fall and winter when it's a little bit colder outside. I really, really do like the salty, sweet aspect of this perfume. I feel like it has a nice balance. So a lot of people say that they can't smell the popcorn note in this, and while it's not a straight up buttery movie theater or popcorn note, there is something salty in here that I feel like represents popcorn. And there is something kind of almost buttery and then syrupy about this fragrance as well. But I really like it. I am definitely a fan of this one. I'm so happy that I added it to my collection. And I just feel like this is perfect for the fall season. I would absolutely not wear this during spring and summer because I feel like it would be way too heavy, way too suffocating, just nasty, not good. So Pure XS is definitely a fall pick for me. The next one I feel the exact same way about, and I finally got to wear this fragrance and really got to know it, and I do really enjoy it. At first it was a regret buy, but now I really like it. This is Angel's Share by Kilian. So I bought this perfume, I believe it was earlier this year, and I didn't wear it at all. I didn't like it when I first sprayed it. I was like, this is so heavy on the cognac. It has a really spicy aspect to it, but I guess from having it sit in my collection, it has gotten so much sweeter, more syrupy, smells amazing. So I believe the scent notes for this one is definitely cognac. It definitely has cinnamon in it, which is where that spiciness is coming from, but then it has a bunch of sweet notes. So it definitely has tonka bean, it has vanilla, also has praline in there, and then it has a woody aspect as well. Again, this is another one. I feel like it's very syrupy, sweet, heavy, suffocating. So I would not wear this any other time than during like fall and winter when the weather is cold outside. And I would love layering this. I take back what I said bad about Kilian Angel Share. I just don't feel like I should buy a perfume and let it sit for a year. It's kind of like I want to wear it when I buy it. But this is one of those examples where the perfume needed to sit and get better for me to like it. The next one I have here, this is probably moving up to my top five perfumes. This one has just been immaculate. This one is top notch for me. I love it. So that's Jimmy Choo Fever. From the very first time I smelled this perfume, I knew I had to have it. This is so smooth, deep, sexy. This is a woman with confidence, very confident in her sexuality, very confident in her body, very confident in everything that she does. That is what Jimmy Choo is to me. This one starts off pretty deep, but it also has like an effervescent bubbliness to it. So it has plum and then grapefruit in the top notes. So I feel like the plum keeps it a little bit deep, but then that grapefruit gives it something sparkling as well. And then it has some florals in the middle that I don't really pay any attention to at all, because the dry down of this is everything. The dry down of this is just so gourmand and heavy and sweet. It's everything you could want. You have benzoin, you have tonka bean, you have coffee, vanilla. It's everything. And the reason why I love this perfume so much, I've said it once and I'll say it again, it's so very smooth. This perfume has so many notes, but it's just a wrap up of smoothness. I don't get anything sharp, screechy, heavy, cloying, nothing. It's just smooth and I love it. And I definitely think that this is perfect for fall. I honestly would wear this year round at nighttime, but during the fall and winter, it's definitely a daytime appropriate type of scent. But that one, I love it so much, and I definitely had to include it in this fall wrap up. The next one is one we all know and love. This is Jessica Simpson, Fancy. Now, I'm reserving this one for fall and colder weather just because I feel like it does better in colder weather. So this one, to me, this is a caramel vanilla floral type of scent, because whenever I smell this, I definitely get the heavy sweetness, I definitely get the heavy gourmand, but it's not just that, it doesn't just stop there. I definitely get florals in this as well. I just think the fact that it has the caramel and the almond in the mid notes, and then it has vanilla in the dry down, I feel like those kind of overtake the perfume before any of those floral and even the fruity notes in this have a chance to really do anything, because this does start off with pear and berries, I believe, but you really can't smell those because they disappear after like 5 minutes with this perfume, and then you're overtaken by a nice sweet mouth-watering caramel vanilla scent, which I'm not mad at. I love that. So Jessica Simpson Fancy, I think, is perfect for the fall. The next one, this is a classic that everybody and their mother mentions when they're talking about perfumes for fall and winter. I don't think there's any video out there on YouTube that does not mention this particular fragrance when it comes to fall and winter, and that's because it is just an essential. It's a staple, unless you don't like this fragrance. If you don't like this fragrance, then I can see why you wouldn't mention it. But Black Opium is just that scent. I ran out of this fragrance and I immediately had to buy it again because, I mean, this is just good. It's a very heavy vanilla, woody coffee scent. But for whatever reason, I can definitely still smell the jasmine and the patchouli in this. I feel like the patchouli is done right in this, and it mixes with the coffee note in here so well. This is a heavier type of fragrance. I know people who wear this as their signature scent during the daytime, but I definitely feel like this is a heavier nighttime type of fragrance. When I wear this during the daytime, I typically mix it with other things just to lighten it up a little bit. But Black Opium is just, I mean, how many times have you heard this perfume mentioned? For good reason. So my next perfume, this is a year-round fragrance for me, but I am definitely including it in this fall wrap-up because I have recently been enjoying it very, very much during the fall time, more so in the cooler weather. This is Guess by Marciano. Y'all know how I feel about this fragrance. Y'all can see the dent in here is massive. It is real. I absolutely love this perfume. This is one that I would always have in my collection. I would always have a backup of this because it is just so good and it's so cheap for what it is. You can get this perfume for, I believe, $20 online. You can't beat that. It's a steal. So this starts off very bright, very citrusy, very tart and tangy. Starts out with curacao, cardamom, also has some grapefruit, I think, in there. It's very fresh when you first spray it, but the dry down of this is just the most amazing thing ever, and I don't know how it transforms like that. The dry down of this is the most prettiest vanilla woodsy scent that you want to smell, and I just love it. I don't know, it's so hard to describe this because it's like some people think this is a gourmand and some people think it's not. I don't really think it's a gourmand. I don't really know how to describe it, but the dry down of this is so sweet smelling. It's perfumey because you still get those wafts of like the grapefruit and the freshness, but the vanilla and woods just takes over when this dries down, and this is just so good to me. I love this, and I feel like I've been appreciating it a lot more in the fall time, so I for sure had to add it to this fall lineup. The next perfume that I have that I want to mention is another one that I pulled out for the fall time, and I don't think I can go back to wearing it any other time of the year, and that is my Gucci Guilty Pour Femme. I'm wearing this today. This scent, so this one is definitely, to me, it's more of a classy, high-end perfume, and when I smell this, I don't really get any specific notes from out of this. I feel like all the notes together just come and make a perfume type smell, if you guys understand what I'm saying. Usually with other perfumes, you can pick out notes and you can detect certain things. With this one, I can't detect anything. This kind of smells like a more modern version of White Diamonds, in my opinion. Because the very first time I smelled this, I was like, why does this smell like my childhood? Why does this smell like my mom? Like what my mom used to smell like. And I remember my mom used to always wear White Diamonds. I don't know the scent notes of White Diamonds to compare to this one, but that's what it gives me. But like I said, definitely a more modern take, because I wouldn't, me personally, I wouldn't be caught dead wearing White Diamonds, okay? I would not. I would not. But I feel like this one is different than that. This one is less mature. This one is less department store perfumey, if I can say that, you know, but it's still perfumey. It's hard to explain, but I love this one and I've definitely been enjoying it more so for the fall time. So I put that in here. The next one is gonna be Moschino Gold Fresh Couture. Now, yes, I think I would wear this in the springtime just because I feel like it's so full of top heavy fruit notes, and then it has like florals in the mid notes. So I feel like you could definitely get away with wearing this during the springtime, because there's like six fruity scent notes in the beginning of this. But the reason why I'm adding it to my fall lineup is just because of the woodsy vanilla dry down of this. There's like three different types of woody notes in the dry down. There's vanilla, there's musk. So I feel like it just goes so perfectly well with the fall season. I really like this fragrance. I feel like this is an uncomplicated, classy, womanly, feminine scent without being too girly and sweet, if you guys get what I'm saying. Because the vanilla, when it dries down in here, the vanilla is not like sickeningly sweet vanilla extract type of a scent. It's not that at all. So I feel like this is definitely a feminine fragrance without being girly and sweet. So I think that is perfect for the fall time. And this bottle, luxury in my opinion. That's how I feel about it. The next one is one that, oh my God, I did not expect to love this fragrance like how I do, but I love it and I always want it in my collection. This is Guerlain, Mon Guerlain. I remember I smelled this in a catalog and it hit me and I was like, I want it, I need it, I gotta have it. And I love Mon Guerlain. I've used, you know, a good bit of it. I really like Mon Guerlain, but I for sure feel like this is only an end of the year fragrance, fall, winter time. I don't think I would wear this during the spring or the summer. So yes, it has that fresh lavender in the opening, but when this dries down to the most amazing soft vanilla that you want to smell. Again, I don't think it's a gourmand vanilla per se, but it's vanilla, okay? This one, it just turns really soft and sweet and cuddle-like. You want to cuddle when you wear this fragrance. So I love it. I love the bottle. It's so simple, simplistic, but it looks luxury and high-end. So Mon Guerlain, I just really, really like this scent. And like I said, it's definitely for fall and winter. I wouldn't wear it any other time. Next, we have Prada Candy. This is a heavy on the cacao, like dark chocolate type of fragrance. I would only wear this one again during the fall and winter. Yes. This is, to me, this is almost like a strictly bedtime fragrance, because this is such powdery, natural cacao, like cocoa smelling. So sweet, so good, but it still has some maturity to it. I feel like if you were to mix this with something, it would give whatever you're mixing it with a little bit of maturity, a little bit of depth, because smelling in the air, this smells good. This just smells like a really heavy, deep, dark chocolate fragrance, and dark chocolate is sexy, dark chocolate is sensual. So that is what I get from this. So spring and summer could not hold this perfume. This is strictly fall and winter for me. Last couple fragrances, you guys, this one is new to me. This is Yes I Am Fabulous by Cacharel. This one is perfect for the fall and winter. This is blackberry, this is milk, this is hazelnut. Like, sweetie, when else are you going to wear this? This is such a creamy, heavy, lactonic, sweet scent. It's like the only time you can wear this is fall and winter, so that perfume can carry and people can smell you and say, wow, she smells just soft and cozy and sweet. The blackberry gives it a little bit of something so that it's not just straight up milk and hazelnut, because I don't think anybody wants to walk around just smelling lactonic. So it has the blackberry in there to do a little bit more for the perfume. But this is good. This is really, really good. And I already came up with a layering combination for Yes I Am that I feel like I will be wearing so much in December, because it's just something about the dry down of this perfume. That sweetness is so good. So Yes I Am Fabulous, Cacharel, check it out. Really good. YSL Libre. YSL Libre Intense. YSL Libre Intense. Heavy hitter Four sprays max. Don't overdo it. It will give you a headache. It's too much. It's heavy and intense. All of my heavy and intense perfumes, I'm only wearing them during the fall and winter because it is not about to take me out in the heat of the spring and summer here in Arizona. It's absolutely not going to. So I tried it once. This was back in May, I believe. Yeah. When I went to school, that's when I bought this perfume and I tried it out and it took me out. Okay. So no, I would not wear this any other time but fall and winter when that cool air is lifting it off of my skin. The wind is lifting it off of my body and carrying it. So that is when I will wear YSL Libre Intense. Okay. Because that lavender in here, even though it's sweetened by the heavy vanilla scent, the lavender in here will take you out for sure. Zara Gourmand Addict. Zara Gourmand Addict is a heavy on the patchouli type of fragrance, but it's so very pretty. Like, this is just a really pretty fragrance. And it's very simple. This is, what is this? This is peach, cassis, and then the patchouli. So it's just a fruit chouli type scent that people seem to hate so much. That's exactly what this is, but I think this is so gorgeous. This is so pretty. But because the patchouli is so heavy in this and it's so perfumey, I think that I would only wear this for the fall and winter. It's going to be a little bit too heavy for spring and summer for me. So that is when I will wear Gourmand Addict. But it is very, very, very pretty. It kind of almost has a syrupy aspect to it from that cassis. You guys know cassis is like from black currants. So it almost has like a syrupy aspect to it, but I think that goes very, very well with the patchouli in here. So that one is reserved for fall and winter. And then the last one I have here is just a little sample atomizer. This one is Dolce & Gabbana, The Only One. I really like The Only One, a little soft, a little powdery. And I feel like it's only powdery because it has violet and iris in here. But it's a heavy caramel coffee vanilla scent and has like a little bit of that mandarin orange in there to like round it and balance it out. But I do like The Only One, and I feel like so many people love The Only One for fall and winter, and I can definitely understand why. Again, it's like the same with the Prada candy. It has that that heavy dark chocolate cacao smell that I feel like would only resonate in fall and winter. So it is strictly reserved for that time in my collection. But this is really, really, really good. I would definitely get a bigger size of The Only One whenever I run out of this little small sample. You would think that it would go fast, but you guys, I have so many perfumes, obviously, that I'm not going through it super fast. But yes, The Only One by Dolce & Gabbana, definitely a fall perfume. So, I feel like I was talking for a long time. That's a lot of fragrances, but those are all of the ones from my collection that I feel like are very fall appropriate that I would, you know, for the most part, strictly wear in the fall time. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope you guys enjoy seeing these perfumes. Let me know in the comments down below what are some of your favorite fall perfumes that I might need to pick up next year. If you guys like this video, you already know, go ahead and give it a big thumbs up. If you are new, sis, definitely go ahead and hit that subscribe button and join the Fragrance and Beauty Army, as well as that bell notification so that you can be notified every single time that I upload a video. And I'll see you guys in my next one. Peace.